Welcome back to Monetized History. I'm Daniel, and today I've been challenged to share my favorite banknote by Square Coin Talk. But after going through hundreds of banknotes, I came to the conclusion that I don't have a favorite banknote. Rather, I have a favorite work of art featured on multiple banknotes. In 1954, a painting was commissioned by the Worshipful Company of Fishmongers, a London livery company established in 1272. Livery companies are basically trade guilds that have evolved into regulatory bodies and charitable organizations. The subject of the painting was the newly crowned Queen Elizabeth II. The title of the painting is Queen Regent and shows a life-size 28-year-old queen standing alone in front of a pastoral background, uncrowned, wearing the vestments of the Order of the Garter. Her solitude echoes the solitude of the crown, alone, as head of the kingdom and the church. The accoutrements of the Order of the Garter anchor her in history and tradition. The order was begun by Edward III in the 1300s and is dedicated to St. George, whose cross can be seen across the left sleeve of her robe. When the painting was first displayed publicly at the Royal Academy Summer Exhibition, it caused a sensation. The attendance for the exhibition that year was higher than any in the past 50 years, mostly due to the popularity of the portrait. At times, the crowd around the painting was reported to be 10 deep. Out of over 1,000 works on display, many would arrive only to see the Queen's portrait. The artist was Italian painter Pietro Annigoni, well known for his revival of Renaissance techniques. In 1927, he was admitted to the Academy of Fine Arts in Florence. He first exhibited 3 years later and soon began receiving awards. By 1947, he had fully rejected the prevailing abstract impressionist movement in the art world and wrote the Manifesto of Modern Realist Painters. He first exhibited at the Royal Academy in 1949 and gained enough interest to have solo exhibitions and begin living in London for half of the year. His acclaim continued to grow, and in 1954, he was commissioned to make what would become his most well-known painting. In the following years, he would go on to paint the portraits of many famous and powerful figures, including the Shah of Iran, Italian shoemaker Salvatore Ferragamo, the Queen Mother, and the Queen's husband, Prince Philip. His portrait of the Queen's sister, Princess Margaret, caused a sensation similar to that of his original portrait of the Queen. Throughout his career, he also composed many religious and allegorical works, including frescoes for churches. He continued to paint throughout his life and passed away in 1988. Annigoni's portrait has been used on the banknotes of 9 issuing authorities between 1961 and 1985. At least 2 different engravings have been made of the painting as well, one by Bradbury Wilkinson & Company, then a subsidiary of American Banknote Company, featured on the notes of Trinidad and Tobago, Malta, Isle of Man, Seychelles, and Rhodesia. The other was made by De La Rue on the notes of Fiji, Mauritius, Jersey, and the Organization of Eastern Caribbean States. Records of why a particular issuing authority decided to use a particular image on their banknotes are hard to come by. Manx artist John H. Nicholson designed the first notes to bear the Annigoni portrait for the Isle of Man in 1961. It's likely this inspired the other British Commonwealth countries to do the same. Although Fiji first used the Annigoni portrait on a stamp in 1956, and other countries soon followed, so he was likely inspired by stamps made around the same time as well. Additionally, banknotes made for the British Commonwealth were almost exclusively made by British printers. The 2 most prominent British printers of that era were Bradbury Wilkinson & Company and De La Rue. It's generally easier and cheaper to use existing engravings when making banknotes, and this likely played a part in the wide distribution of this portrait on paper money. And now for the trivia. Are you ready? Which banknote issuing authority featured the Annigoni portrait on their money for the longest time? Let me know on Twitter or in the comments if you think you know, and I'll post the answer tomorrow. That's all for today. I hope you liked it. Do you have a favorite work of art from coins or banknotes? If so, let me know in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe.